What's up, royal family? Welcome back to the Keys to the Kingdom, where we drop all the keys to the kingdom. Dr. G is in the building. If you are new to the royal family, come on and hit that subscribe button. Join us because we are kings and queens, actively living out our purposes, full of positive vibes, changing lives, and loving on the Lord, right? This is the place to be. You do not want to miss the messages that come through on my channel. Shout out to my faithful family. Yeah. Always in the building, holding it down in the comments. I love y'all so very much. I'm truly blessed and grateful to share this journey with you all. Listen, baby, like, comment, and subscribe. Like, comment, and subscribe. Okay, comment, especially if this is your first time hanging out with the royal family. Let us know where you were tuning in from so we can welcome you. Okay, blessed to have you with us here on the journey. Listen, baby, let's get into this message, okay? Because God, hallelujah, he wants to use you to be part of his grand plan that he's bringing to this earthly realm. Glory be to God, okay? I was in church service this past Sunday, and the message was so phenomenal. I really feel the Holy Spirit just telling me to pass the information on to you all, okay? Because it was such a blessing, all right? And so, yes, God wants to have you, my love, you, yes, you, be a part of his grand plan, okay? What he is bringing to this earthly realm, okay? His new purpose, his new world order, hallelujah. He wants to include you in it, okay? He wants to use you to be a miracle for someone else, or for, he's going to use someone else, excuse me, to be a miracle for you, all right? And so these people who are going to be used to be either miracle givers or miracle creators, right? You have to, miracle receivers or miracle creators, you have to be willing and open to remain in step with the Holy Spirit. You have to be willing and open to have your plans, your day-to-day things, your day-to-day functions, okay? You have to be willing for God and open for God to interrupt the mundane, okay? So who out there is very anal, you're very structured, you like to do things in a particular order every single day, you drive to work the same exact way, you go home the same exact way, you eat at the same spot for lunch almost every single day, you know, you just used to doing things in a robotic format, right? And then you get upset if you're like me. I'm guilty of this in the past because God had to work on me, right? I'm no longer like this, but I can say that in the past, I would get upset because I'm such a perfectionist. I love things to go to plan in order as I imagined it to, okay? Based on my to-do list, I have 1,000 to-do lists for everything. These are the things I need for grocery. This is my workout schedule for the gym or for the park. This is my work schedule for my business or for the ministry, right? I like things to be in order. I like things to have a structure, okay? And when that plan gets thrown off, the queen's emotions, my attitude used to not be happy about it, okay? I will be the first to admit. But who else is out there just like me, just how I was, okay? Listen, baby, God is saying that the supernatural, hallelujah, happens in the natural when you allow him to interrupt your plans, when you allow him to have his way happen, when you allow him, the Holy Spirit, to show up and to be activated in you and to move through you, okay? He's just going to be requiring some of you to be more present. Be more present. Don't be so robotic. Don't be so systematic. Be present. Speak to the people that you're around when you're walking. Don't have your head down in your phone. Be observant, okay? See what's needed in the environment and in the places where he's planting your feet, okay? Be generous with your hands, with your lending, with your giving. If God is instructing you to do something, speak something, give something, right? You want to be open, right? And in step with the Holy Spirit so that he can perform the supernatural right here in this natural earthly realm, okay? That comes by you being open and allowing him, hallelujah, to interrupt your plans, to interrupt what you had scheduled for the day. Glory be to God. Can he put himself on your schedule? That's what he wants to know. Will you allow the Lord, the Holy Spirit, to put himself on your schedule? Okay. Matter of fact, can you get on his calendar? Can you get off of your own calendar and get on God's calendar? Okay. And you celebrate and do what he needs you to do, what he needs you to be a part of, where he needs you to be. Glory be to God, because he's saying that divine interruptions leads to divine miracles, and divine miracles leads to divine movements. Glory be to God. This pastor was on fire. Hallelujah. And she was a guest speaker, so her name slips my mind at this point. But I was just like jotting down all of her nuggets. I'm trying to say notes and nuggets at the same time. Oh Lord, fix it. But yes, she was hitting it. Okay, like this is legit the truth. This is how the Holy Spirit operates, and I'm a witness to this because I've had it happen to me, where I went from being upset that he was interrupting my plans to the point where when he interrupted my plans, beautiful supernatural occurrences would happen, and I would actually be thankful for it. I would be grateful for it, okay? And sometimes we're so closed-minded to what the spiritual realm wants to do that we miss it. We can miss God. We can miss God. So don't allow your emotions, your typical day-to-day things to make you miss the miracle, the big thing that God wants to do, that God wants to fulfill in your life, okay? Or for someone else. Don't allow your emotions. This is the second thing. Don't allow your emotions to keep you from the miracle. Okay. Because that's another thing. When you get in your feelings, you're blocking out the Holy Spirit. Okay. And what he wants to perform in your life. Glory be to God. And glory be to God. You might be limitless, but the God you serve, no, excuse me. You might be limited, is what she said, but the God we serve is limitless. Okay, I know y'all heard that before. We may be limited in our way of thinking, in our way of knowing, in our way of being, but God is limitless, and he's all-knowing, all-being, okay? He's everywhere, okay? And he can do anything at any time. He's just looking for a willing vessel. He's just looking for somebody that's eager, that's obedient, that's ready to listen, okay? Hallelujah. That's ready to yield. Type in the comments, I'm ready to yield. I'm ready to yield. Glory be to God. You're yielding to the Holy Spirit, the leading of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You said your faith journey isn't rooted in you. It's rooted in the one who's faithful. Your faith journey isn't rooted in you. It's rooted in the one who's faithful. So sometimes, my loves, we don't want to do things that God wants us to do because we're trying to do it based on our level of thinking, our present emotions about that person or that thing, okay? And maybe we just, like, we hear God and we would like to do it, but then we don't trust ourselves to do it. We don't trust ourselves to do it. We're like, nah, I can't do that. I'm not ready for that. Strong enough for that. I'm not wise enough for that, right? You're serving the one who's faithful is a reminder that you're not doing nothing at all. The Holy Spirit living inside of you is going to be the one that's going to be doing it. He just needs your hands and your feet and your heart, okay, to go forth, okay, to rise up and go forth and do what he's calling you to do. Like, allow his spirit to do it through you. Hallelujah. And I know that that might sound strange, but the Holy Spirit will literally give you the words. If he's going to ask you to do something, he's going to ask you to say something, he will literally give you the words. But you have to be present enough to hear them so that you could write it down or so that you could just speak it, right? Impromptu, okay? Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Some of you might think like, hey, my time is valuable or my sleep is valuable. But from my experience, the Holy Spirit don't care about none of that. He don't care about your time and he don't care about your sleep. Okay. There is some times where the Holy Spirit is having me intercede for somebody on somebody's behalf. And it's 3, 4, 5, 6 a.m. in the morning. And trust me, the queen wants to be asleep. I want to be in bed. I want to be knocked out somewhere. Okay. Relax. Z's. Gone. But no, I have to be up. And again, the next day or a few days later, I get those praise reports and I see that person's life and I'm like, wow, it's working. They're changing, Lord. But you did that, God, because you was waging war last night or in the morning, you know? So it's beautiful. I allow the Holy Spirit to just take over and he does what needs to be done because he knows what needs to be done, okay? And he just does it through you. Hallelujah. 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 You need to get it together. Get up in here, okay? Become a part of God's grand plan for this earthly realm. Hallelujah. So listen, my loves. We're about to end here, okay? Think about it this way. When God invites you in, because I feel like this message, he's going to be drawing some of you in to the grand plan, right? To remind you of your purpose, to remind you like, hey, you said you was going to do this for me. You on the team. Come on now. Show up, right? He wants you to know that it's a ripple effect. Your obedience, your yes to him is a ripple effect to those around you, to the rest of the world. Okay. And so you, my love, when you do what God tells you to do, you might represent 5,000 people. Out of that 5,000 people, you're going to touch at least one person's soul. That one person's soul that you touch is connected to 10,000 people. Okay. Out of those 10,000 people that one person's soul touch, hallelujah, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Out of those 10,000 people, they're going to touch two more people, right? This is how small it starts, but look at the impact. And those two people are going to be connected to 50,000 people, okay? And so now, through one person, by one person, everyone has been changed forever, okay? And it is not by your power, not by your strength, but by the name of Jesus that operated within you, okay? The Spirit. Hallelujah, of the living God that operated inside of you, okay? So trust and believe that this is not something you need to get worried about. This is not something you need to be flustered with. This is something that you should be excited and eager to do, because it's just the Holy Spirit doing it in you, okay? It's not going to be you. It's not going to be your face. When I was getting my doctoral degree, during the beginning of the program, basically, one of our professors said, sometimes we get nervous presenting and worried because we're thinking that everybody is like caring about us, you know, like, oh, they're going to be looking at how I sound, what I look like, and, you know, judging what I'm wearing, stuff like that, right? It's just, you're always thinking about me. But if you go in with the mindset, because all of that me stuff, that's going to worry you. If you go in with the mindset of how can I be a servant? How can I give? I have information that people need. So how can I open my mouth and articulate it so that they can receive it? You're thinking about being a server, a giver, a lender. That takes the attention off of you, right? Who you are, what you're doing. And it puts it on the people that is going to be receiving, right? And so some of you are called, right, to be givers of a miracle. Some of you are called to be receivers, to be the recipient of a miracle. But God can't do it without you. He can, but he doesn't want to. I'm sure he could do anything that he wants on his own, but he doesn't want to. He has chosen you. And so he needs you to rise up. He needs you to rise up, okay? And he needs you to partner with him. Partner with him on this journey. Partner with him on this journey. Glory be to God. And allow his new world order to come to pass with your yes, okay? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Type in the comments, Lord, I give you my yes. Lord, I give you my yes, okay? And you better actually go out there and do it, okay? Because I'm going to be checking on y'all. I'm going to be checking on y'all, okay? I love you so very much, royal family. That is it. That was the message pretty much in summary. I didn't go through everything, okay, that she spoke about, but it was so phenomenal. Yeah, divine interruptions equates to divine miracles and divine movements. So you're being invited to be a part of divine movement of the kingdom of light. Hallelujah. Of God's kingdom. So say yes. Say yes. Say yes and be blessed. Do not forget to be a blessing. Go visit the queen at infinitelyhealed.com. You can shop Empowered by Love. Okay. And counseling will be opening soon for everyone interested in trauma-informed counseling or faith-based counseling. I got you. Okay. The queen about to be up and out here with you all again. I love y'all so very much. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Okay. And thank you for everyone again, as always, who gives your super thanks, who supports this ministry financially, or even when you plant your seeds of the word. Hallelujah. It always encourages my spirit and it keeps me going. It keeps me going out here, okay? So y'all are truly always a blessing to me and my own little personal small miracles each and every single day, okay? So I love y'all. Until next time, baby. Go be great. The song he playing right now, it's a live musician out here. He said, it was just my imagination. But anyway, I don't even think that song is relevant, but I love it. It's like an oldie but goodie. And I think my father used to play these songs all the time on his little mansion. Oh, yeah. Okay.